og velkommen til Asker-TV, Askerfotballs nye digitale satsing på web. Her vil du få innblikk I livet på Føyka. Du skal bli kjent med folka I klubben. Vi skal ha gjester. Vi skal snakke om det som skjer ut på banen. Mitt navn Dag Vegil. Jeg ny medieansvarlig her I klubben. Med meg ved min side så har jeg en gammel kjenning her på huset. Espen Falk. Velkommen.
Takk, takk.
Du klar for å ta Askers digitale satsning til nye høyder?
Ja, og det moro å være en del av det. Vi har sikkert mye å kunne fortelle våre fans om som ikke kommer fram I det daglige. Litt sånn fra innsida på Føyka og litt fra miljøet. Så tror jeg det kanskje neste skritt I satsingen vår. Fra Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, og så må også vi ha vår egen Asker-TV.
Mm. Men det blir ikke noe sending uten en gjest, og det selvfølgelig naturlig å invitere en av de største navnene her I huset, på huset, I klubben, sjefen selv, Kevin Nicol. Velkommen som første gjest.
Takk, takk.
Velkommen.
Takk, Kevin.
Takk, velkommen.
Kos ikke.
Ja, bra. Intimt og fin studio her. Kevin, hva status nå? Fire kamper igjen av årets sesong. Vi fikk noen resultater med oss I helgen, med både Raufoss og Fredrikstad tap. Men det gjenstår fortsatt fire tøffe kamper. Hva tenker du?
Well, first of all, it was a great weekend for us. I don't think we could have had it any better, to be honest with you. I never envisioned both Alta losing at home and also Fredrikstad losing at home, you know. I think it was always a tough game for Raufoss to go up north and play Mjolnir, who are a very good home team, of course. But we had to do the job ourselves against Stabæk, and I think we made it a little bit tougher than it could have been. 2-0 up at half time, I think, you know, I was wanting to push on and score a few more goals there, but unfortunately, we dipped down a little bit second half, and to give credit to Stabæk, they caused us a lot of problems for a good 10-15 minute period there. So I was delighted that the guys showed a bit of character to get back into the game, and obviously win it 4-2.
Og nå venter Grorud borte på lørdag. Det blir en tøff kamp, altså.
Of course, yeah, and we've played Grorud before, and they've caused us problems. But that'll give us a good deal of motivation, I think, coming to this game, especially being so close to the top two in the table as well. And it's a game that Grorud will want to win as well, because they're only one point behind us. So it's a game that the winners take all, really, in terms of keeping in contact with the top two. A draw might not suit both teams, but a draw might keep us in it to a certain degree. But we're going to go there looking for 3 points against a good ball-playing team who can cause a lot of teams problems.
Kan du si noe om skadesituasjonen da? I troppen?
Yeah, I think everybody's ready basically. We have a few little bits here and there regarding small injuries on players, but everyone's ready apart from Patrick Carlison, who's going to be out for the season. Unfortunately for Patrick, he got injured, I think, 2 or 3 days after we started up in the summertime. And he was really important for us first half of the season. I think we didn't win a game without him until we played against Honeyfoss at home. So yeah, that's a blow for us because we're looking forward to him and Sokol playing together. And a good bit of experience in the middle of the park there. But yeah, we've got everyone ready, which is mainly due to the new pitch we have. It's such a difference to us. We've had one muscle injury since the change of pitch, and that was Sokol, who had a little groin strain. He was out for 2 weeks. But yeah, training's been good all the way since summer, and the results have been good as well, so very happy with that.
Hvordan ser du på, for eksempel, årets Askelag kontra I fjor og året før? Hvordan har utviklingen vært på, yeah, på det mannskap og laget du har hatt?
I think defensively we're a more solid team, to be honest, but I think Aaron Jones coming in has really helped us defensively. I think the signing of Martin in the summer, Martin Vigno, with his good legs in the middle of the park, has certainly given us a little bit of edge defensively as well to cover spaces. It's a year ahead again where the guys get a little bit older and more experienced, a lot of young players. Menard's had a great development, not only offensively in terms of his movement and finishing, but the job that him and Ludwig does for the team is a big boost to us playing a 4-4-2. The two strikers really have to work hard. And I still think there's a way to go. You know, we've got Ivan Farlos-Dahl is a great talent. He's got, you know, a long way in terms of understanding, you know, to go, but he's got the talent with the ball. Yeah, but Andreas has had a good development in goals as well. So there's been some surprises in terms of development. Some guys have taken big leaps that I never thought was there, you know, which is a great bonus to us. Yeah, and I'm very happy with the team as a whole. You know, the way that they work every day in training is what we focus on mostly. And the development's been good, the whole way the team's developed as every season it happens. But I think going into next season, wherever we are, what league we're in, we need a better pre-season, we need a better start to the season. And if we get that, then I think, you know, we'd be at least have a better start and we could be flying at the top of the league, you know, for a good period.
Det jo litt sånn som I år, som I fjor, så kom vi litt sent I gang. Det kanskje en av de tingene du snakket om, at vi fra neste år kicker I gang når vi...
Yeah, definitely. I think the conditions in the winter, it was hopeless at times, you know. It was snowing the pitch constantly every day. And looking back, I might have just done running training, you know, at the end of the day. But I believe in a lot of work with the ball. I believe it's all football should be with the ball all the time. That's all our training we do. But in those conditions, I probably should have changed it and just done running, which is not fun at all. But looking at this season with a new pitch, then hopefully it can be much better. And I'll sit down with Lars Rune Hasselstad, who's the fitness coach, and we'll make a good plan because it has to be better. And we've also got the responsibility of developing young players, which is important. Their health and their fitness is in the right way, so they can have a good career.
Du snakket om de unge spillerne. Rekruttene har også gjort det godt denne høsten. Det startet kanskje litt tøft før sommeren, men resultatene har gått oppover.
Yeah, and that's due to the guys being fit again, you know, getting the guys off the treatment table, as we say, and get back on the pitch. And once the squad was stronger, we could help the junior lads who play for the second team a lot. And once you get four or five older experienced guys in the second team, you pick up points naturally, you know. And the guys, the professionalism from the Allag boys has been great. The junior teams had a tough time this year, and that's probably because a lot of them had to play for the second team, you know. And it's a very young junior team as well, so it's been a big challenge for them. But they've started to pick up results also, so it's been a pleasing this season. And it's went our way with a lot of victories in each arena that we've competed in.
Det sånn, Kevin, at alle våre gjester, de skal få lov til å fortelle litt om innsiden I et fotballmiljø, kanskje komme en god historie, sånn avslutningsvis. Du har jo vært I en del klubber I Norge, Haugesund, Moss, ja. Strømskos I Mjøndalen, Asker. Har du noen gullkorn å fortelle litt sånn fra innsiden?
The best one from Norway would have been in Haugesund, to be honest. I think there were some characters in that dressing room, and there's a guy called Mikael Antoine Curie, who's been around a fair bit. He's had a lot of clubs in England and Scotland, but we had him in Haugesund, a French guy. And there was one time where there was two Polish guys we had, and there was one guy in particular who weared fancy underwear, I could say, you know, you could use your imagination there. And so Mikael took his underwear and hung it on the top of the roof in the garderobe. So when he came in, the Polish guy wasn't happy, naturally. So he was going to get Mikael back. So the next day in training, we trained at a place called Torvista, and they had wooden floors. So Mikael Antoine Curie had new Timberland boots. So the Polish guys knew this obviously, and they got nails and a hammer, and they hammered his boots into the garderobe floor. So and also put rocks in his jacket pockets. So he tried to put his shoes on, obviously. His feet got stuck on the floor, eh? And he put his jacket on and he got weighed down with the weight of the coat. So then we played Honeyfoss. This was just before the start of the season. So we played Honeyfoss away first game of the season at Deco Liga. I remember it clearly because the flight was delayed, so you know, we're a little bit late for the game. And we warmed up, and then we would come back in the garderobe after we warmed up. The two Polish guys on the bench, so they stay outside, so they stay like messing about with the ball a little bit. And I look around in the corner of my eye, Mikael's got a pair of scissors, he's cutting up their travelling clothes, you know, so their folks and all that, and their t-shirts, he's cutting them all up before the game. So I'm thinking, what is he doing? We've got a game to play, you know, we want to win. So it turned out, obviously, the Polish guys after the game come in and see their clothes and stuff. So they had to go to Gardermoen wearing their match strip with their shorts and socks and Haugesund top. So that was quite funny when you see them walking about the airport like that. But Haugesund was some place. I think Rune Skarsholt had a lot to deal with there. There's so many nationalities and different people, you know. So it was, there was always something on the go.
Og her I Asker, her alt ordna former til enhver tid.
På stell.
Yeah, there's not so much going on here, I don't think. We've got some characters in there as well, you know, and like Sakini Graywell and Alagi Sangyang and Bahaydin Selina, they never shut up, you know. But most of the boys are very nice boys and nice guys.
Ja, vi skal runde av, men har du en oppfordring til Aske-publikummet? Det en kort reise til bortekampet på lørdag. Om å få med seg mest mulig Aske-børinger til Grorud. kanskje vi alle kan si det. Ta turen til Grorud på lørdag. Avspark klokken 4. Ikke sant?
Yeah, it is. And yeah, you know, Grorud is a small place obviously, but I'm sure we could get at least 50 people from Asker, you know, it can't take much. Small distance to go and I've been to a few away games before that a small group can make so much noise and it can make a big difference. And this is a cup final for us. We have to win this game if we're thinking about first place at least. And it'll be a great boost for the whole time if we manage to push on and get promotion, you know. And, we're not far away. It can take 4 victories and we're there. So a lot to play for. And the biggest game so far this season is on Saturday for us.
Da ønsker vi lykke til på lørdag, så håper vi å se masse Asker-folk der. Takk for at du så på. Takk for at du kom. Espen, vi tilbake snart, ikke det?
Ja, ja, nye gjester og nye sprell, kanskje, vi får se.
Ja, vi får se. Til neste gang. Takk for nå. Perfekt.
Pretty harmless.
Yeah.